Good morning, members of the public and legislators. I was sent a cease and desist letter from the Sandia Creek Road Committee demanding that I delete my YouTube public service announcement video and social media posts where I discussed my objections and allegations against the Sandia Creek Road Committee and the manner in which they obtained a building permit to construct two private toll gates, which in my opinion and from my investigations used illegal and unethical maneuvering with public officials. I believe they sent to me to wrongfully threaten and coerce me as a method of retaliation and harassment, and is in violation of my First Amendment right to free speech in connection with this very public issue. The Sandia Creek Road Committee obtained my personal email dated June 9, 2021 to County PDS planner Nick Kutafidas, warning him he may have been misled by members of the Sandia Creek Road Committee and others in order to obtain the gate permit under false pretenses and confidential details relating to my discovery. My email should have remained confidential and not provided to the Sandia Creek Road Committee in order to protect me from retaliation. As a result, I have faced retaliation in the form of a cease and desist letter and now fear for my safety and well-being. I had hoped the proper local authorities would view what I discovered first, but to date, they have had no interest and refused to view any of the evidence that I had to provide them. I wish to submit my statement to, due to the walls of inaction by our local government and the threat of civil and criminal prosecution in order to defend and protect myself, and because I believe the cease and desist letter was written to portray my opinions as lies and criminal actions and to threaten and silence me. The statement in my letters are my opinions that any person would reach with all the relevant facts and evidence that I know. I believe that I have uncovered backroom dealings by public officials in order to approve the Sandia Creek Drive private toll road gates. I wish to keep releasing more videos about my investigation relating to the public matters until the proper authorities begin to investigate, whoever that may be. I'd like to submit my full statement for the public and legislators today. Thank you very much.
Thank you, ma'am. I didn't want to interrupt you, but could you please state your name for the audio record?
I'm sorry. My name is Shauna Django.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Shauna Django. I was elected by my community members in 2019 to be the chairperson of PRD 20 in Daly Road, located north of Fallbrook. 1 year ago, Supervisor Desmond inexplicably asked the public works staff to conduct a pavement condition index on 100 miles of the private roads within the 68 PRDs located throughout San Diego, and also directed the staff to return in 180 days later to make recommendations to the PRD program that was established in 1999. As a result, thousands of property owners were informed how much money each PRD would need to bring the roads to a certain PCI level, or risk having our existing PRDs dissolved, which, by the way, would be devastating for my community and the other 68 PRDs. Without a PRD, we are left with no assurance that our roads are going to be maintained in a manner in which allows safe passage for our residents. My PRD is the largest permanent road division with 19 miles and 340 people that have to maintain that. The county does not in any way contribute any money to the PRDs. They are self-funding by the property owners who agreed to tax themselves in order to maintain the roads in their district. And I just have one question for Mr. Desmond. Why did you ask the county to do that 1 year ago today? I've met with you twice, and both times you could not provide me an answer, so I would really like to have one. Thank you.
I'd be happy to talk to you offline. Thanks.
You asked the county to look into the PRDs. Why?
I don't know that I asked the county to do that. This guy just gave me a letter about the PRDs. This is a private road?
Private road.
Okay.
I'm the chairperson of PRD 20.
I represent 347 people. And now, because of what you asked the county to do 6 months ago, they're going to come back with some recommendations. And the recommendations are that we all pay anywhere from $5 to $10 million in the next 5 years.
To who?
All of the 347 people that live out in Duluth are responsible to maintain those roads.
Okay.
We have private roads because our land developers did not develop our roads to the public county standards.
Okay.
Therefore, we are all responsible, just like the Sandia Creek are responsible for their roads, the people in Riverside are, and so are we. This has all triggered a huge, huge,
wow.
You have no idea. In fact, I have created a film that I'm getting ready to release, and people inside it, you were mentioned in it.
Yes.
I would like to send the film to you before
sure.
I actually do release it.
All right,
too.
Okay. We'll have, okay. What would you name?
My name is Shauna Jango.
Shauna, okay, Shauna. Hey, Jack. How'd you spell your last name?
J-E-N-G-O.
Oh. Shauna? Right.
Yes.
All right. Well, we'll take a look. My head is filled.
I get it. And listen, by the way, I really appreciate everything that you do. I am not a political person. And you know what I mean? It's like, who do I relate to? Who do I, every time you came here, I was like not expecting anything. And then everything that came out of your mouth, I'm like, yes, yes.
I'm a regular person, like everybody else.
And that's why I was so surprised at what I have been discovering. And I'm going to talk to him. Hunter. Thank you
yes,
so
ma'am.
Much. We need to talk.
Oh, do we?
Yes, we do.
Thank you very much, Mr. Chair. On this one, my only concern, I'm fine with the county services areas and the runoff issue, but the permanent road division, I had several questions on this one. This is basically private roads where people put into a fund, and then the county makes the commitment to maintain these roads. And what I noticed, particularly in the four of these six are in District 5, and I just started asking about the first one, where the rate increase, some of the people are paying zero into the fund, and they're going to be asked to be paid up to $150. And I asked the question of, well, when might these folks see this road improvement take place? And I was told in 30 years. So obviously there's not enough money going into these funds. Because I think people have the expectations if they're paying the county or paying a fee into the county, that then they have the expectation we're going to maintain the roads. But if we're not collecting enough money to do that, and 30 years is way too far off, I think we need to kind of set the expectations so that the residents understand what it is they're paying for. And, you know, maybe I would, as a resident, if I were paying, I'd expect, well, maybe every 5 or 10 years it gets resurfaced and the potholes are taken care of. But some of these funds just don't have the money to do that. So, and I know many of these have been in place for several years. You know, even on the first one, that's PRD 13, we're raising it from zero to 150 annually, and understand that still is not even going to be enough to maintain the road itself. And it's primarily that this, the residents' own limit that they imposed on themselves. What I don't want to do is overpromise and underdeliver. I really have a question other than maybe to direct staff to come back within 180 days with changes to this policy to ensure that we've got the adequate funds for these private roads, and that maybe we come back with a level of maintenance and repair that's understood, maybe even a PCI level, so that we, these things going forward, actually have the funding available to maintain the roads, and we are able to keep the promises we make, because we, the taxpayers, you know, are using extra dollars from outside for these private roads, I think is not the right way to go. And if we're willing to do this, we need the funds to adequately maintain and sustain the roads. So that would be my direction on this, is to add the motion for the staff to come back with 180 days to make sure these future PRDs are adequately funded to ensure satisfactory road maintenance and repair and sustain a specific PCI level as determined by staff on the roads where we make these promises. Is that, do you have any comments on that at all, Sarah? Or, yeah.
Chair Fletcher, Supervisor Desmond, thank you very much for your comments on this item. I know that certainly for our public works staff, this is an area that they would like to come back with some options for board consideration. We do have 68 PRDs, and we can provide you with some of those options of if you wanted to change the policy, what the considerations could be and the resources that would be needed for that change.
Thank you. And I realize this is probably going to be an increase to the residents, but at least they know the expectations going in, as opposed to underfunding these road, private roads that we're supposedly maintaining. So, thank you. Thank you.
Yes, hello. I would like to speak.
I'm sorry.
I would like to speak.
Okay. Who is this?
My name is Shauna Django.
Okay.
Good evening. Thank you.
We have a brief amount of time period. Jeff, will you do the timekeeping for us? And please give us a 1 minute warning before the end. Go ahead.
Thank you. Good afternoon. I was sent a cease and desist letter from the Sandia Creek Road Committee demanding that I delete my YouTube public service announcement video and social media posts where I discussed my objections and allegations against the Sandia Creek Road Committee and the manner in which they obtained a building permit to construct two private toll gates, which in my opinion and from my investigations used illegal or unethical maneuvering with public officials. I believe they sent it to me to wrongfully threaten and coerce me as a method of retaliation and harassment, and is in a violation of my First Amendment right to free speech in connection with this very public issue that affects local communities and the public at large. The Sandia Creek Road Committee obtained my personal email dated June 10th, 2021 to County PDS Planner Nick Koutafidis, warning him that he may have been misled by members of the Sandia Creek Road Committee and others in order to obtain the gate permit under false pretenses and confidential details relating to my discoveries. My emails should have remained confidential and not provided to the Sandia Creek Road Committee in order to protect me from retaliation. As a result, I have faced retaliation in the form of a cease and desist demand letter and now fear for my safety and well-being. I had hoped the proper local authorities would view what I discovered first, but to date, they have had no interest and refused to view any of the evidence that I had to provide them. I wish to submit my statement due to the walls of inaction by our local governments and the threat of civil and criminal prosecution in order to defend and protect myself. And because I believe the cease and desist demand was written to portray my opinions as lies and criminal actions and to threaten and to silence me. The statements The statements in my letter are my opinions that any person would reach with all the relevant facts and evidence that I know.
Well, it started out down a dirty road. Started out all alone, and the sun went down as I crossed the hill, and the town lit up. The world got still. I'm learning to fly, but I ain't got wings. Coming down is the hardest thing. Well, the good old days may not return, and the rocks might melt, and the seed may burn. I'm learning to fly, but I ain't got wings. Coming down is the hardest thing. Say life will beat you down and break your heart, steal your crown. So I've started out for God knows where. I guess I'll know when I get there. Fly around the clouds, but what goes up must come down. Hardest thing. I'm learning to fly.